All right, Hopkinton High School, welcome to our latest episode of HHS Today. I'm your host, Cam Richardson. This episode is full of segments produced at the end of last semester. You know, while we're learning the skills. Up first, it's Trivia with Rio.
What is the largest state in America?
Alaska.
That is correct. What is the largest state in America?
Alaska.
Correct. What is the largest state in America?
Alaska.
That's correct. What's the largest state in America?
Either Texas or Alaska.
It's Alaska. Who was the second president of the United States?
Jefferson.
It's actually John Adams. Who was the second president of the United States?
John Adams.
That's correct. Who is the second president of the United States?
John Adams.
That's correct. Who is the second president of the United States?
John Adams.
That's correct.
I'll bet I could do well at trivia, but no time for that today. Our next segment is a new one, but destined to be a classic. It was produced by Joe, and it's called Show Me Your Lock Screen.
Now show him your phone screen.
Don't touch my phone.
Show us your lock screen, please. Is it on?
My lock screen's Travis Scott.
That's fire.
It is a planet.
Can you give us a story behind why you picked that?
You know, it came with the phone, so.
This is my cat, Nori. She's a Siamese cat. She's very cute.
Can you show us your lock screen, please?
My lock screen is Buzz and Woody.
That's deep.
That was very cool. And by the way, Alyssa gets the credit for coming up with that concept. Great job. And now let's roll our first interview clip by Quinn, where he talks to Dr. Zaleski.
So I just have a few questions here. So what is it that you do?
So I'm the director of student services, and you know, oftentimes folks will think of me as the director of special ed because I am titled that way as well. And just, you know, it's an all-encompassing title. What it really means is I service students from pre-K all the way through age 22, young adulthood. My job entails making sure that all the students receive both special education and other supports that they may need. So for instance, students who have IEPs have different needs, like some may need speech therapy, specialized instruction, and other supports. And my job is to really work with the team to look at those IEPs and make sure as a district that we're giving all the students that what they need in accordance with the IEP, and also to make sure that we're assessing what they need to put it onto the IEP. But in a nutshell, really my goal and my job is to make sure that all the kids pre-K through age 22 have a range of supports and services.
So with that being said, what would you say is most rewarding about your job?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question, because I don't get asked that question often, because, you know, when you're working, you just come to work and you do what you need to do.
Yeah, I
really love, Quinn, the fact that I can make a difference in these students' lives.
Thank you for all that you do.
Oh, thank you so much for taking the time. I feel truly honored that you asked me to be interviewed. This is truly the first student interview I've done since I've worked in the district. So I really appreciate you, Quinn. Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
Honestly, there are a lot of people doing an outstanding job for the Hopkinton school system that we don't even know about. And that's why our district is number one. Thank you to all of you. Now, how about a TV show review? Bridget is all over that with the Vampire Diaries.
Hey, HHS. It's Bridget O'Connor, and I'm here to review a Netflix show called The Vampire Diaries. The Vampire Diaries is a show about vampires and humans interacting and connecting throughout the show, but mainly about high school drama and the setting of horror around it. I would recommend this show because every episode is a good cliffhanger leading to the next one. You can get hooked on every episode you watch. Also, The Vampire Diaries has characters that you can relate to, but obviously not the vampires in the show. A lot of people who watch shows on Netflix wait for more and more seasons and series. Well, there's no need to wait here, because there are other series to watch that relate to the same original background as The Vampire Diaries. Some are the originals and legacies. Those are both good too.
Nice, I love that show. Our next segment has us wondering, what if we have more remote days? How will I handle that? Well, Nick was wondering the same thing.
I would like waking up later, but I would miss seeing people at school. The breaks that we have, and I just kind of like being online a little bit more.
I'd miss my friends. The flex box.
I wouldn't like it.
Me neither.
Yeah, that wouldn't be very good. I like to take some extra time to make a nice lunch. The other day I had a nice egg sandwich. It was really good.
I do the same thing. I also like texting my friends, like Tommy Bernard.
That was pretty cool. And again, thank you to those who participated. All right, we thank the previous HHS TV for leaving us some cool segments. That is a wrap on semester one, unless we find any more segments laying around. We hope you enjoyed watching what they enjoyed making, and look for more HHS today, as early as next week. Find more episodes and content on our website, hhs.today, and tell us what we should be producing at hhstv.hillers.org. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.